Welcome to another exciting episode of Any Up, the only sports show where the hosts pay for their bad predictions. I'm your host, Trey Moe.
And I'm your better host who don't take L's, Dylan Garcia.
Stop, sir.
Did it hurt, bro? Like, when you just followed all that pride?
Okay, I took the L, all right?
What did I tell you, bro? Do not go against Cali.
True.
Listen to me.
Roll the tape.
Hello? Hello? Yeah, I'm in the library. Let me call you back.
So you go birthday, you have $1,000 money on you for your birthday.
Now who's gonna tell my mom? I'm not telling my mom.
No, I helped you pay your student loans. I gave you money to pay off your car. I gave you money for all that.
Who's gonna tell my mom? Because she loves you. It's a picture of you on her refrigerator. Yeah, she doesn't even have a picture of my brother on her refrigerator. Yeah, you got a picture of you on her refrigerator. She doesn't even have my brother. Sorry guys, I'm leaving, no. No, you don't do that to someone who gave you... Yeah. I'm sorry, ma'am. You don't do that to someone who gave you their virginity, okay? It's not right.
That really had to suck, the fact that, like, you had to do that and you don't have a girlfriend. Like, that's kind
of... First of all, I choose not to have a girlfriend right now. Like I'm in L.A., okay?
Yeah, like you choose losing teams.
Whatever, bro. Let's get into this week's matchups, all right? First up, we have the White Sox versus the Cubs.
A.K.A. the Crosstown Classic. A.K.A. the Windy City Showdown. A.K.A. the Red Line...
Stop, okay? We had enough AKAs, okay? Now, the Chicago rivalry has been going on since 1906.
AKA the North Side versus the South Side.
Are you done? I thought I asked you to stop with the AKAs.
Okay, I will. AKA, I'm done.
Okay. Now, traditionally, the White Sox dominate the Cubs in a three-game series. But rookie Jose Abreu has been hitting home runs like it's his job.
That's because it is his job, bro. I mean, I get what you're saying, but you're not remembering when you guys got swept four games in a row.
That was last year. This is this year.
Okay, right now, are you taking the Sox?
Yes.
Cubs.
You taking another L. I got my first win. Now, the next matchup is the Washington Wizards versus the Indiana Pacers. And who would have thought the Washington Wizards would make it this far in the playoffs?
Nobody. I haven't figured it out yet, so I think I'm going with the Pacers, though.
Pacers? Man, you crazy. First of all, let me tell you something. They struggled against the Atlanta Hawks, right? Atlanta Hawks don't have any notable franchise players besides Paul Millsap. And who the hell knows Paul Millsap?
Nobody.
I know Paul Millsap. No offense, Paul Millsap. I like you. This is not the same team that played Miami last year. They're no longer hungry.
The Pacers...
They're no longer hungry.
...are the hungriest team in the NBA right
How?
Now. Paul George, Roy Hibbert, and George Hill. They want it so bad. I'm going with my gut instinct, which is a big instinct. Pacers, final answer.
John Wall and Trevor Ariza are playing out of their minds right now, okay? There's no way the Pacers are gonna get past them. Those boys are balling. Finally, our last matchup is for you, Kevin Bedoya. It's another huge rivalry. Game 4, the LA Kings versus the Anaheim Ducks.
AKA the freeway face-off.
What did I tell you about using AKA? Stop it. Now, this has been huge. This is the first time these two teams have met up in a series.
I'm kind of torn, though, bro, because I live right in the middle in between, like, L.A. and Anaheim. So if I'm in my room, I'm a King fan. If I'm in my living room, I'm a Ducks fan. And have you seen how, like, they warm up?
Quack, 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 quack.
Whack, whack, whack. They took off the cue. They know they whack.
Once you take into consideration that Ryan Getzlaf has the second highest points this season and the Ducks have beat the Kings 4 out of 5 times, I'm gonna have to roll with the Ducks on this one.
You make it too easy for me. Like, you just pick the losing teams and I just be like, okay, I'll take it. They came back from a 3-0 deficit. So, what else do I gotta do besides take the Kings? I live here, it's my spot. I'm a King. Now let's check out this week's dares.
Number 1, sit in an ice bath for a full minute. Number 2, wet your pants in public. Number 3, eat a full can of dog food.
Well, there you have it, guys. Those are this week's dares. Don't forget to comment below and vote on which dare you like the most. And if you have any good ideas for dares, tweet them to us. But hashtag any up.
Don't forget to follow at @AllDevDigital.
My @is@TreyMoShow.
I'm @Dylan_Garcia.
Follow us because every other day we're going to be doing a lot of trash talking. You can see me rub that L all in Dylan's face. I'm your host, Trey Mo.
I'm Dylan Garcia.
We'll see you guys next week.
Any up. Lob City Trick.
More like Flop City Brick. Yeah, there's no way the Clippers are gonna win, okay? Donald Sterling killed the momentum with that phone call.
Okay, first of all, he only hates half of Blake Griffin, so that's the main point.